Hi, Paul Donovan here from avtechnician.ca, your channel about tips and tricks for AV technicians. Today I want to talk about equalizers in those sound systems equalizers, but also I want to talk about a special unique item called FBQ, which is a product line that helps you use an equalizer. First off, EQ means equalizer. Many of you may not have realized that, but that's what it is. And what you'll often see is you'll see in your mixer board will have a few little bars, slide bars, that are a mini EQ for your system. You also have in each channel, quite often you have a low, mids, and highs. My hand should go the right way. Lows, mids, and high dials, that is also considered EQ. Then you can get an EQ that is a separate box, quite often stereo, sometimes stereo side by side or stereo top and bottom. And these are EQs with a bunch of sliders, often 20, 30, 40 sliders, each one allocated to a certain frequency of sound. Now, a lot of people use the EQ buttons sometimes for the wrong reasons, but unfortunately it's the only reason that really is done a lot in the AV world. When we're often having speakers speaking and they're wandering around with microphones and maybe moving towards speakers a little too closely, we have to watch for feedback. And so when we do this, we want to try to find the certain frequencies of a room that can cause trouble. Now, good technicians will use just their ears and slide up and down or dial up the low, mids, and highs to try to clean out some of the things. A lot of times it'll be the mids that you'll be turning down to eliminate feedback to give you enough volume, because the average user just expects that if you've got a microphone, you just turn up the volume and it should just work. They don't realize that when you turn the volume up too much, you get a lot of squeal and feedback. So our job with EQing is to try to reduce that. So what a lot of times I'll see a lot of technicians, AV technicians, especially the setup crew, who will just bump down the mids, anywhere from 20 to 30% down. That way they can get enough volume and they eliminate a lot of feedback issues. If you've got a full track 10 channel or 30 channel EQ, you have a lot more control. Now, there's a company named Behringer, and I know there are other companies that do it, but Behringer has a product in their mixers and so on called FBQ, Feedback Q, EQ coming from the EQ. This is a button that you turn on, and what you do then, and what I tell is, if I've got a room full of, visitors, delegates there, or these early stages and a few people, everybody watch out, I'm going to make some noise. That's what I'll tell them, and because what I do then is I will get all microphones turned on, all my EQs are leveled straight across, all of my channels are all straight up and down 12 o'clock, and then what I do is I turn up the volumes of some of the microphones until I start to hear some squealing. Now, you can use your ear and sort of guess where those ranges are, but Behringer boards have this FBQ button. If you press the FBQ button, the little red lights on each of the channels will go off. And you think to yourself, oh, that turned off my EQ. What it did is that FBQ, the board, is actually now listening to the sound. So now you slide up the volumes a little bit until you start to see some squealing. And what you'll notice in the bars is the little lights will light up as you reach that frequency. And it helps you determine that, this is a 100K frequency or this is a 50K frequency. And what you can do is you can crank that one channel down and it helps clear off the squeal. And it happens across the board. So you want to have your lapel mics or your headset mics or your handheld mics or the wired mics. You want to have them all turned on so that all these microphones are picking up the sound of the room. And then you can find what frequencies are going to cause the most difficulty. So the best thing for you to do is, in my case, I like it because a lot of the boards I work with are Behringer boards. I turn on the FBQ and a lot of my coworkers don't know what it does and it's often turned off. I turn it on, then I turn up the microphone volumes and as I notice the channel squealing, I'll just bring it down, bring up a little more volume until it started to squeal and I bring down the ones that the lights on. And what ends up happening is as I pull off the frequencies, I push in more volume than I'm actually ever going to need for the room. But what the advantage is that during the event, if I have all the microphones turned on, I'm hopefully not going to have any squealing and feedback issues happening. So FBQ really helps me to be able to determine it. Now, I have seen people use apps on their smartphones or tablets that will also do the bouncing and tell you which frequency is causing the trouble. But it is actually monitoring the sound from the actual room, whereas the FBQ thing on the Behringer board is monitoring the signal itself and hearing feedback within the signal and catching it ahead of time. In fact, Behringer makes a device called the Shark. I've only ever seen one of these devices, and I've seen it used by a guy who actually knew how it worked. A Shark is like FBQ on steroids. It will handle frequencies. It'll handle blocking frequencies automatically. It finds all the frequencies that are giving issues and automatically brings them down. It has a little bit of compression and limiter built into it as well. The only thing I don't like about the Shark is that it only attaches to the single output of the board, which means it doesn't do its work on individual channels. Now, I did see one time in a photograph where somebody had a bunch of Sharks lined up together for each channel. Shark was lined up in the insert stream, so that there was a Shark for each of the microphones. That was very smart, but those Sharks are not cheap. And so anyway, I've seen a guy who really knew how to make it work, and it was amazing. He basically gradually turned up the volumes across the board on the whole thing. And as the Shark learning, he pushed a button and said, learn. And as it was learning what frequencies were causing troubles, and it was adjusting the EQ levels for those frequencies. And it was also taking a little bit of compression and limiter activity on the channel as well. But of course, it was only working on a single feed of the output from the board. So it's taking a cross section across the board of all the microphones. Remarkable device, check it out. If I can remember, I'm gonna put a link in the article that will point to it. So there's a brief lesson, a brief tip on using EQ, and of course the FBQ feature that is available in a lot of Behringer mixer products on the market. Thanks for watching Paul Donovan, AVTechnician.ca, tips and tricks for AV technicians. Please click like if you like this video. Click subscribe so you can subscribe and follow along as I create more videos. Check out our website at www.avtechnician.ca for more tips and tricks for AV technicians. Thanks for watching and have a great day.